Hello and welcome back to yet another episode of Jak and Daxter, the very first Jak game in the trilogy. I mean, I guess there's really like four, but one of them isn't in the collection. Anyway, this is from the Jak and Daxter HD collection. Look out for more videos on this in the future, but anyway, we will be jumping into it on the last episode. This is episode number 3, by the way. On the very first episode, we got the backstory going. What? These things respawn? Like that as well? Like just on while you're on top of them? Okay. Anyway, on the first episode, backstory, plot, all of these things were laid out for us. Second episode, lots of exploring and questing, if you would, and collecting. Lots and lots of collecting and, you know, doing some tasks. And in this episode, expect the same, but also we have a little mini boss fight, I wanted to say, for the start of this video, so I thought that'd be really fun. So, if we go ahead and head on over here, let's just grab this nice little orb, and then what could happen? What could happen after we have the awesome power cells, huh? Are we gonna fall into the floor? Maybe. What happens once we do that, though? What happens? Do you want to know? Can you handle the truth? I don't think you can handle the truth. Now, that will take you back up, but... damn, we're actually gonna have to wait a second. Oh, there's a thing behind you, dude! I love how they put those, like, in the environment. That's so nice. That was my bad. That's completely, like, no excuse for that. That is just me being stupid. Okay, so let's go. Let's actually play. Let's not die anymore. This, I totally thought I had another hit. I forgot that the tentacle was stupid. This is the boss fight, by the way. Mini boss. Big flower demon thing. Look at that. Look at that thing. This thing's scary. This thing's freaky. All right, so... pretty much, I think they hurt whenever they have the spikes. I don't remember. Yeah, I'm pretty sure they do. We'll figure it out. Oh, shit. How do I hurt this thing? I forgot. Oh, this is how. Okay, so it, like, rests by giving you footsteps, pretty much. All right, so we gotta avoid these things at pretty much all costs. That'd be nice. And then you're just waiting. Is how you beat this boss, is you wait a while. And then, of course, rule of threes. First two hits aren't gonna kill it. All right, let's round them up a little bit. Oh, wow, look, three enemies now. Ah, crap, but the spikes come out eventually. So you gotta be careful with it. Whoa, I should have not been able to make it out of that. I did. The game got me. They're like, no, nope, you glitched that part. We're gonna eat you now. Sorry, dude. You know what? It's okay, I'll take it. See, I'm still kind of getting in the swing of the controls and everything. I'm surprised I did so well at the fishing thing, which is kind of why I was making jokes about it. I mean, not surprised. Like, if I was playing on the PS2, the results totally would have been the same. That wasn't the surprise. But the surprise was that I'm so, like, used to this different controller. Because I have not played a PlayStation 3 game actively in... since the system came out, maybe? Like, a very long time. I'm so scared! What are we gonna do? Alright, we figured that out. We'll beat up this baddie, and then hopefully we won't take any more damage. The only bad thing is the pattern doesn't go with all of them. Oh god, and then that guy tries to, like, eat you. Look! He does it, like, the entire time. He's still doing it! Like, that's ridiculous. You'd think he wouldn't be able to hit you after a while, right? You'd think the boss would be over it. Now you're over it, buddy, aren't you? Yeah, let me pound you to the ground. That's kind of a jerk. I mean, I did, like, mess with his dead body, though, so maybe I'm kind of a jerk, too. Black Thumb, ta-da. Nice little silver trophy. I know nothing about trophies. And then we'll just give it a little hop. And, see, I told you we'd get those eventually, didn't I? On the last episode, I said we'd get those eventually if you weren't tuned in. Now you know, okay? So, are scout flies different in this area? What orbs am I missing? So, I know of one. Oh, duh, connect the beams. I didn't think that would count for that. And then there's a secret one, apparently? What is the secret? Huh. Where's the secret one? I don't actually remember. I'll connect the beams. Whatever. We'll continue doing that. Now, the easiest way... Ah, fuck, dude. Ow! Ah, that really hurt. I'm just punched a chair. Dude, that's not funny. You don't need to laugh. Come on, man. Fisherman thinks it's funny. What a jerk. The easiest way is to look up in the sky. The next easiest, like the first easiest way, is to just go back to where you activated the first one. Now, I do remember off the top of my head, because since I've played this game a number of times, I do remember it's right here. But if you didn't know, just go back to where you set up the beams initially, and then follow and wait. So now you can see this is where the next one goes. You just follow the line, and then you continue setting them up. So, hold on, let me dodge that snake. That was almost pretty bad. Look at this huge frog thing. And it's so weird because you think that the horns would like screw you up. Oh my god. I always miss hitting it with your dash attack, but I always get it with the spin. I don't know if it's because the thing is like so thin or what. Where is it? Is this the next one? I'm pretty sure this is the next one. I don't think it's any further than that. But it very well could be. Alright, so let's go over here. Open this up. Open it up. Use it, please. And that is the last one. Now, you could probably tell where it is. I mean, this one lets you see it quite a bit better. And then the camera panned. So, it has a lot more distinguishable stuff around it than some of the other ones. Like, some of the other ones are just like, it's a pole and there's some trees or something. Whereas this one's like, yeah, there's platforms and crates and etc. It's pretty easy to distinguish between it. So we just go, I knew I was going to do that. How do I always get to two hits? Like, how does that always happen? Is that my third death? I think that's my third death already. Maybe fourth, which I really don't like. Like this, I'm going to get way better. I wouldn't say that I'm bad. But I'm just making like really stupid mistakes. Okay, so like I don't even need to hop that way. I can just I just glitched there. Game, please don't get mad that I glitched. I'm sorry. You don't need to punish me with something stupid later. And then that's just on the beach. So that'll be the easiest to get around to. See? Look at that. Ta-da. Wow. Okay. So apparently you take fall damage. I didn't know that, or I guess I just forgot that, probably, is more likely. I wonder, is it better an excuse to say you didn't know it or that you forgot? I feel like saying you forgot is better, but I feel like it doesn't hold up as well. Like, I feel like if you say, oh, dude, I just didn't know, then it's like, oh, okay, well, you just didn't know, but you sound like maybe like you're stupid. Whereas one's like, you're not stupid, but like, come on, man. You can't forget everything. You can't use that excuse too much. I mean, the same goes for the other one. You can't use it that much either. And this, I think, automatically sets it up. I don't think I have to actually go there. I think I just, it's good to go. All right, so here are all the beams. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's just good to go now. And what do you know? Ta-da. Connecting the village energy beam. Yeah, definitely. All right, so where's this last orb? That's what I really want to know. I thought that it was back. It's either like one of three areas. I think I know where it is. Not 100%. I do think I know. Oh. Excuse me, I don't know if you could hear me yawning. I was trying to not talk so I could hide it. But then I was like, shit, it's probably weird that I'm not saying anything. Maybe I should say that I yawned. But I always yawn in video, so like I feel like it's pretty annoying. Please don't take fall damage. Oh, man. That would have been scary. I should have done his quest last. Like, dude, shut up. It's not funny. Like... The only laughable thing is how much difficulty that dude had with it and how much I did not. Like, I didn't miss any fish. I didn't screw up once. Did I not open this? I'm pretty sure. No, I opened that earlier. Okay. So let's check this area. Wait, did these loop? Ah, shit. Okay, so dashing is incredibly difficult in water. I can't. I can't while I'm swimming. This, yeah, it's difficult. Don't do it. Alright, alright, keep going. Unreliable, got it, got it. Don't fight any more creatures, please. I keep taking two hits, and it's really annoying. I really don't want to do it anymore. Oh my god. Oh, excuse me. Alright, now this is a bit of a risk it for the biscuit kind of thing. Now, obviously out here, there was a power cell, but I think there might be one around here. For some reason, I think. Now, you know, actually, I'm pretty sure I'm wrong. Oh my god. Thing almost ate me. You know what? We'll leave here. I don't actually know where it is. The only other place I could think of that it would be is in the little temple that we just came from. But I thought I checked all the secret areas, so I don't know, dude. I'll try and figure it out. We'll see if we can see what all's on going on. Nope, not today, buddy. Sorry. Uh-oh, I meant to roll and then jump, not just jump. What the fuck? What did I hit? Okay, well, you know what? Joke's on me. All right. Okay, that's fine. Oh, I remember. It's just right here. You go in here, you get it. Ta-da! I know, very hidden, right? Mm-hmm, definitely. Not actually. Normally, I get that before I even go into the temple, I think. Maybe I always get it after. I don't know. Anyway, we did it. So now, it's time to go back to the village. Why, might you ask? To collect our rewards, you may be saying? No, not really. I just want to skip this area and go to the next one. I'm not actually going to collect our rewards yet. I'm just going to go ahead and move on to the next area. Look at this. Let's go check out old Fish Grip's speedboat at the dock. Now, my favorite thing about the little dash is it isn't annoying like the one in Zelda. Like, you actually cover, you know you're getting somewhere whenever you do it. Like, it's a very sizable dash, so it's not like you're doing it and you're like, is this even really making a difference? Like, how does this speed you up that much? You don't make a weird yell or no, there's no noise with it. There's no, like, audible thing. It's pretty easy to do as well. I mean, I'm just comparing this to everything, like, not just a Zelda dash. There are plenty of like, little tricks that people do to speed up a little bit, and some of them have clear downsides, and, like, the game creators probably didn't even think that people would use it that much to go through the levels. Alright, I want him to throw the... Okay. So these right here, these little bags that they're slinging are explosives. So I want to stand right here, and then I want him to do that. Now, the thing with this, him throwing these, I actually don't need him to do it. I can go do it myself later, but I'll go ahead and get it over with, I guess. Oh god, that was scary. I didn't realize it was right next to me until, like, the last second just about. All right, sling your stuff, dude. Come on. Sling it again. No, closer. Closer. Your aim will improve one day. Ah, you hit me! No, don't blow up my orbs! Come on, only two more left. You could totally do it, dude. Come on. Look, I'm over here. I'm jumping for you. I'm doing it in anticipation. There you go. Alright, and then just one more. Come on, buddy. Come on. I'll jump for you. I'll jump. Hit me. Hit me right in the head. Bump my noggin. There we go. Cool. And now we're good. Why does he always do two in the same spot? Stop, you already blew it up. Like, I'm not gonna stand there. I don't want you to blow me up. That's the whole point of me doing it. Alright, so there's another power cell right over here, but there's a thing that jumps out of the sand. But it doesn't matter, because we'll walk around. You aren't tricking me, game. I've played you before. Look at that. Look at it in the background. Thing actually looks pretty cool. Hey, how you doing? I'm pretty sure almost all of the damage I take is from me rolling and not being able to control it that well. It's so fun, dude. Look, I almost died right there too. What I'm gonna go ahead and do is I'm gonna make my way over to the green eco generators, because those give you health, and I apparently need it. So, on our way... Oh, cool. I actually didn't smash into them. Break the rock. Full health. Thank you very much. These weird dog things won't shut up. Quit barking at me. Come on, man. I'm just gonna punch you. Like, why do you want to fight? What if they don't? What if they actually don't want to fight? And if you don't hit them, they, like, become your pet? It's probably a little out there. I think that's something I'd want to do in a game. Like,
have something ferocious, like, charge at you. But if you don't attack it, like, you know, you assume that imminent death is like, right around the corner, right?
You see this giant, like, death claw swing at you. But it, like, hits you and it, like, just brushes your face. Like, it, like, moves one of your hairs out of your eye or something. Instead of attacking you, yeah, that'd be great. Yeah, shut up, dude. Come on. I was talking over you. No one could hear you anyway, okay? Quit laughing. It's not funny. It's not funny, okay? Alright, so if we head on over here, we can go find this sick bird, as you may be able to hear in the background. You can hear the bird in the background, is what I'm saying. No, you can't. I don't actually know what I was hearing earlier. I thought it was the bird. Maybe it wasn't. Alright, Scout Fly, we want you. Why are there enemies up here? What are you doing, dude? What are you even... Why?
Are you near the egg yet?
Yes, I am extremely near the egg. No, there's just dogs and egg. I don't know that this is a good idea. Hey, there's no hay!
Now beat me down here by the egg.
Well, which way do I want to go? Do I want to walk all the way around or take the express elevator? I took damage. Oh God. Hey, let's talk.
Oh my! I hope the poor deer's okay. Here's a power cell for your valor.
Yeah. Oh.
No!
Look, isn't that cute? It thinks you're its mama.
Ah! I'm not your mom. You see any feathers here?
Oh, love at first sight. Oh. Listen, boys, I'll take this little chick back to the village with me and work with the sage to take care of her.
What just happened? Like, what? What just happened? Okay, so we got the egg. That was kind of weird. Let's head on over here this way. Get the scout fly. And then pick up these orbs. Now, there actually are some more orbs and power cells. There's a plethora of goodies in this area, okay? I mean, we just got here. Don't you worry. We still have plenty of things to find. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to head over here, okay? There are some orbs down there. But I actually think this water's deep. I'm not sure how deep it is. Oh, but what we can do is beat up a bird. Isn't that cool? We can just punch it right in the jaw.
We have to get to the power cell before the pelican starts.
Oh God, dude, this pelican is not gonna wait for us.
Dive for those orbs, Jack. Dive.
Yeah, I don't think the pelican's gonna wait for us, dude. Oh, it totally is. Get out of here, bird brain. You can actually mess that up pretty easily. Like I almost did. If I messed up my first dash, I don't think I would have gotten it. I think I would have been just shit out of luck, dude. Alright, so let's keep on moving. There are lots of orbs that we can go underwater for. These right here. I think this is supposed to teach you the diving mechanic, but it's not really a mechanic. Like, you go down for like a second, and then you have to go back up. See, like, I can't even move over any further. Unless you hold it down all the way. But there's very little wiggle room, I guess, is what I'm trying to say. Like, you gotta dive or you gotta not dive. Like, how am I even picking these up? It's so weird. You know, water is supposed to make it, like, more difficult to see. Like, mess with your perception. But, like, that's not what the game is doing. It's just messing it up because you're diving way too low. It has nothing to do with, like, refraction of light. Oh, God. All right, come on. Keep going. There we go. Okay. Cool. Lots more to go, though. So don't you worry. We will waste plenty of time swimming. One more. Yeah, all right. So, now we need to make our way over here to the dry land because I'm tired of swimming. And if we go ahead and head on over here, pick up another scout fly and a crab. Look at that, pet crab. I mean, we gotta take him to the hospital, dude, it'd be fine. You know, it's like catching Pokemon, right? You catch a Pokemon, you gotta beat it up first, and then you take it back to the nursery. You take it to the... What is the place even called? What? The Pokemon Center, there we go. Yeah, it was just like, it's just a center, right? It doesn't have some special name. No, not really, no awesome elaborate name. It's just a center, it's a Pokemon Center. It's the place where you take your Pokemon. Man, that's weird. I would think that they'd have like some cool name. Oh, dude, awesome. Okay, so I actually wasn't really thinking about this before. That vent right there, you may have heard her whenever we defeated that boss. She said, oh yeah, that vent opens up other vents around the world. So that happened, that vent was locked before. You wouldn't be able to get up there. What you'd have to do is, you could glitch it before. I'd normally glitch it about halfway, I think. There was some eco that I could pick up and I could get going, but I couldn't do all the platforms and I couldn't open up the vent. But once you actually go through this, through the previous area rather, then you can actually go through and do everything. Now, I wonder if I can shoot, like, a big bag of stuff. No, hold on. You use the thing. I mean, how do I shoot? There we go. Wow, he's pretty happy about it. What if I can hit that thing over there? Dude! No way, I totally could if I wanted to. Alright, you know what? We'll actually try it. What? What? Like, hit it. Come on, man. Maybe you can't hit them. Maybe they're just background. Like, he's not moving. Yeah, that is on him. Okay. Alright. Apparently, those are just background. There doesn't seem to be anything else to hit. I can hit those boxes, I guess. But I don't think I actually need to break them. I think the eco might break them. I don't know. I didn't want to wait. I'll go ahead and break them. Just because I'm not 100%. And then we'll exit. And then I'll try and make my way back over. I don't actually know if you can roll and jump. Well, not like that. Not like that, you can't. Huh. Uh-oh. Don't get eaten, please. Cool, we're good. Alright, so I think what I'll do now is I'll just try and finalize this area. I'm not sure how much more stuff there is, actually. Because we are getting a little into the episode. You know, we are getting a little longer than we normally would. And I don't want to, I'm okay with having longer videos, like, normally my videos are only 10 minutes long, sometimes less than that, sometimes a little more. And I'm okay with having longer stuff, but I don't want to have stuff that's too long to where people, like, don't have the time to watch it, okay? That's not what I want to do. I don't want to inconvenience you with your entertainment, you know? Like, I don't want to have to make it where you have to, like, set aside a bunch of time and, like, make an activity out of it. Like, just do it whenever. It's the hope with this, okay? Now, in actuality, I have no idea what people do. But that's the hope, the goal. So I do edit out some stuff sometimes. Sometimes I like put stuff in, even, you know, there's a bunch of different stuff that happens with it, you know, give or take in one way or another. Let's keep looking around. Again, I want to just try and, it'd be much nicer if I could just wrap up this one area all in one go. Daxter, are you okay, dude? I think there's something at the end of this one. Let's go up here. Nope, just some orbs. Okay. Oh, yeah, here we go. This is what we want to happen. Boom! Rocks. Just kidding. That wasn't the cool thing. The cool thing is a power cell fell out. And do you know where that is? It's right next to the green eco generator. Let's check it out. That's what happened whenever I moved all the birds, by the way. That's why Daxter was laughing whenever you do it. So you kind of know, like, hey, there's something about it, man. You better do it. So get the fallen power cell and the scout flies. There's one more power cell, and I don't actually remember where it's at. And I feel pretty stupid about that. But where is it? All right. So I think it's... Okay, so if we keep moving this way... It's not over there. I will go get the last scout, I guess. There's another scout to my right, and then I'll keep looking around for a minute. Hopefully I can quickly figure out what I need to do, but if not... We can wait until another time, another episode, whatever. That's fine, I guess. How do I... I don't actually remember how to get up here. Maybe I have to, like, scout out the area a little bit. Yeah, I don't actually remember how to get up there. I'll just leave it for now. Really? Really? Am I not going to be able to grab that ledge? Okay. So if we take a look... Right there. Oh, okay. I see how I do it. Okay. That should work. I think. I'm guessing I know how to do it. And I will. I will definitely try to do what I think I'm supposed to do. I think the other orb's just, like, kind of hidden somewhere. I have to walk and find it. I don't think it's, like, do some special task for it. But now what I want to do is go show you how to get that scout, and then I'm going to end the episode there. Like, I don't want to drag on too much. Now this, I'm assuming if I just do that, I'll land and be able to get all these orbs and then be able to go back up and get this lovely scout fly. So, ta-da! As you can see, we have collected all but one power cell in this area. And that would get us to 20. We would be able to go through everything, but I'm not gonna do that yet. If it's just, I kind of want to do it off screen. I'm not going to do it off screen. On the next episode, we will go back into the village and we'll get things sorted out, okay? We won't be in this area. We'll move on. We have a whole new area we can go to. Not the Fire Canyon, but we can go to that in a minute. We have the island we can visit again, which we will do in the next video. And then we can come back here, get another power cell, and then we can collect everything from all the villagers. And then, on top of that, we can turn in some of these awesome precursor orbs into more money. So, thanks so much for watching. I definitely appreciate it. Again, I would love feedback on, like, is it worth me not talking during cutscenes? Only on some cutscenes, on every cutscene, not at all, whatever, say whatever. What do you think? Let me know in the comments below, and thank you so much for watching. I do appreciate it. I do think it's kind of cool. And if you want to subscribe, that would be fantastic. Until the next video, take care.